After my last Bunker Tech video, I was convinced I was done, that the myth of AFK hammering was thoroughly dispelled, that we could let the remaining true believers of the Church of Base Tech and AFK hammering peacefully live out the last of their days as an ancient relic of less sophisticated times. They, however, felt different. They felt their point of view was misrepresented or misunderstood. That point being, it is not the AFK hammering itself that does anything to progress tech. The AFK hammering is just there to make sure that your character doesn't get kicked from the server for inactivity. In other words, the AFK hammering prevents against AFK kicking. And as we saw in my previous tests, one of the most important factors determining the speed of tech progression is having your spawn set for the entire duration of the tech unlock period. So, making sure that you do not lose that by being kicked for inactivity seems like a sound strategy. This, however, leaves another question. When do you get kicked for inactivity? The only AFK timer I am aware of is the AFK timer for people in vehicles, even though I never had it happen to me. So let's first confirm that that indeed is the case and it does exist. Luckily, this is easily testable. I built a truck in the backline hacks, drove to a secluded spot and went AFK. After an hour of being AFK, a message popped up in the top left informing me that I would be kicked for inactivity, which promptly happened 22 seconds later, and I ended up at the instruction screen that is before the main menu with a message saying I was idling in a vehicle too long. This suggests that not only the active slots, driver, gunner, engineer, commander, etc., in a vehicle have this AFK timer, but that also the passenger seats have an AFK timer. Just to kill the cat, I did an extra test where I drove a truck to a remote spot, got into the passenger seat instead of the driver's seat, and went AFK. Once again, after an hour I got the message that I was about to be kicked. And after a total of 1 hour and 22 seconds, I was indeed kicked to the instruction screen again, with the same message saying I was idling in a vehicle for too long. Now all of this obviously only confirms that an AFK timer exists for idling in vehicles. Not necessarily something that combines well with AFK hammering. To test for an AFK timer for people on foot, I simply went to a backline map, made sure I was out of the way and within cover of AI defenses, and went AFK. After 1 hour, nothing had happened yet. After another hour, still nothing happened. 3 hours AFK and still nothing. Then, at 4 hours into the experiment, a false alarm. 5 hours went by and nothing happened. 6 hours AFK and still nothing. 7 hours AFK and still nothing. 8 hours AFK and still nothing. 9 hours AFK and still nothing. 10 hours AFK and still nothing. Half a day AFK and still nothing happened. Eventually, after 18 hours, the developers had enough of my testing shenanigans and did a server restart. Something that wasn't really appreciated by my game client, which promptly froze. Not that I noticed this, since I was literally AFK and only found out that the last 6 hours of my 24-hour recording were just one single frame after I had reviewed the footage. Despite this mishap, I feel confident enough to state that there is no AFK timer for people on foot. I forgot, however, that there is an AFK timer for people on foot. Escrat9er reminded me in one of our conversations. In update 55, an AFK timer got introduced for queued hexes. Under other changes, one of the items that got implemented is players that are AFK in a region that is queued by friendlies will be kicked after a period of time. Testing this was going to be both easy and very time consuming. I waited for a day where large queues were formed for a region and joined that queue. While moving slowly through the queue, I kept an eye on the queue's length to make sure that the queue would still exist while I was in the hex. When I was next in line to join the struggle for Westgate, there was still a queue of 15 people behind me. Arriving at Rancher's Fest, I took a little hike to a relatively safe spot and went AFK. And, just as with the vehicle AFK kick, after 1 hour I got a message that I was about to be kicked for inactivity. And I got kicked after 1 hour and 22 seconds. Now where does that leave us? With an AFK timer, that might influence the time you have your spawn set at your bunker base, and AFK hammering potentially countering this? Is it a good idea to AFK hammer to help you avoid this AFK kick in case your hex becomes a queued hex? For a community that is insistent that queues are one of the biggest scourges in the game, especially the ones into contested and heavily thought over hexes, I'd say the answer is pretty simple. No. As a matter of proverbial fact, I would say that AFK hammering is borderline griefing. Potentially keeping player slots in a server occupied that could be filled with actively participating players. Or to quote one of the beaters, and one of the most famous AFK hammerers ever, John L., you may say that I'm a griefer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us. And the amount of people that can get into a queued hex because of all the AFK hammerers will be none.